Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note to YouTube channel, and welcome to another episode. So today I want to cover quick command. Now, I've always said I'll do a video on quick command once I discover a use for it, and I have been trying and it has been difficult, but I'm glad I looked into it all day today and I was able to find some useful and interesting things about it. So let's begin. So one thing about quick command is it works best when you have the S Pen out, and when you don't have it out, the use for it is kind of limited. To launch quick command, you need to do a swipe up with the clicker depressed, but if you do these curvy lines, you'll notice they don't register, so it needs to be a straight line, mostly straight, and it needs to be of a certain distance. So let me give you an example of where it does not make sense to use it and where it actually comes in handy. So would you ever see yourself doing this? I'm going to do that call quick command, right? You take out the S Pen to make a phone call, and then you swipe up and you do call Aaron. And sure, it works, right? But why wouldn't you just, you know, just hit that phone icon and type in AA for that same number? But here's an example where it actually does come in handy if you have the S Pen out. For example, you wanted to do a search on maps for Getty Center. And I would say it is a few steps more convenient than doing this, opening up the Maps app and doing a search and then typing in somewhere like Hearst Castle. There we go. So when you have the S Pen out, those quick commands work and they do save you a few steps. Now, will you remember to use the quick commands when you have the S Pen out, or will you normally go to your normal routine? Well, you have 2 years probably with the Samsung Galaxy Note 2 to get used to these optimized ways of using it. So maybe there is something there. So did you know that quick command acts differently on certain apps with certain search functions? So the best example I could give you is open up SNote, and you could see when you launch quick command, there are some extra verbiage on top here. You could search for file names. So we'll search for all the pop-up notes I've created within December 29, and in a couple of seconds, it'll find all the notes I've created on that date because it is embedded into the file name. Okay, and it works differently in Evernote. In Evernote, when you launch quick command, you can't search for file names, but you can search for words that you've typed into the note. So I know I used the word hamburger on here, and as you could see, it should find the note where I have the word hamburger in there. So those are just two good uses for quick command that have these extra search functions, and there are a lot of apps that support this, like YouTube, Player Pro, Music Player, Video Player. So let's get into adding custom quick commands. So open up quick command with that gesture and hit on the settings icon. And I want you to take a note of these five up here. These five are the only apps that support launching of apps with special commands after them. I tried really hard to find other ones, but you can't. You could only launch apps. So let's do a select an application. And this does take a little bit of time. So you could see these apps on top here. You could add additional quick commands for these five apps on top, but everything else that you choose, it'll be just launching of apps. So for example, let's choose a clock app, right? And then you could either choose a symbol out of here, right? Or you could just write a symbol that it would recognize. You can't just do any kind of weird squiggly pattern. It needs to be some kind of character. Okay, and as you can see, it is command only. You cannot add like $, 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. to set the alarm. So you could see it got added to the bottom there. Let's just test it. And just to extinguish all doubt, you can't do anything like that, right? But you could just launch the clock app. Now here is an interesting use for quick command that I didn't see coming. So when you do add a command, there's a select function slash settings. This is actually setting of something like power management profiles. So let's select that, and just for our amusement, let's select everything on here. Okay, let's click on done. And we'll want to create a power profile that considers battery. So we'll call this, let's not make that mute. Let's make sure we get our phone calls. But let's turn off GPS, Wi-Fi, auto screen rotation. Let's turn on power saving mode, blocking mode, data network, all that stuff. Okay, and let's click on done. And we'll call this equals one. There we go. Let's click on done. And we'll call this power profile, power save. So you could see it got added to the list, and let's test that real quick. And I just want to show you I have every option on here except power saving on. So let's do equals one, and then it says switching all this stuff off, and then it's going to apply this profile. So when you go check on your settings here, you'll notice it did turn off everything as promised, except there were no settings for NFC and S-Beam. Maybe they just forgot to put that in there, but yeah, I thought it was an interesting place for to put a feature like this, because I could see myself using it outside of Quick Command, but why I have to go to Quick Command to use it. If you guys know where I can go to enable these things, maybe I just can't find it. But anyway, let me show you one thing you should not do when using Quick Command, which is create and add commands using letters. For example, I'll add a command for another command for internet search, just as an example, and I'll do command and keyword there, and I'll use the letter H. Okay, let's click on done. So to test it, I could just do H, and I could do weather, and it should launch the internet and search for the term weather. Okay, so that works fine, but remember the example I showed you with Evernote. When you launch Evernote, you could do a search. It has a specialized search. And then when you do something like hamburger, right, it conflicts. It actually goes to, uses H to launch the app, and then searches for hamburger, which doesn't make sense. So to close out this episode, I found an interesting bug that maybe some of you will find useful or at least amusing. So just open up any app, but on top, make sure you open up YouTube. And just letting you know, Quick Command actually responds to the app on top. So YouTube has that special search capability. And let's search for Psy. And you would expect it to search for Psy on top here, but it opens up another YouTube window. Oh, you can't really get it to do this any other way. So let's open up that video, and let's also play this video as well, and they'll both play eventually because it's loading a lot of data. So anyway, if you haven't been to my channel yet, please come to my channel and check out my 100 plus videos on the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe, because I create an episode a day so that you could get the most out of your Samsung Galaxy Note 2. Once again, thank you for watching.